Hi again, I'm David Maurice, Certified Financial Planner, the only Certified Financial Planner for Worthwhile Wealth Counsel.
And I'm Andrew Worley, Associate Advisor at Worthwhile Wealth Counsel.
And today we're bringing you a late-breaking great news, and this is for long-term investors, not for traders, not for timers. But one of the hardest things for long-term investors to do is to stay the course when fear is rampant. And we sort of believe that the media is doing its job the best it can at selling fear. So we're going to bring you some counterbalance points. These are real. They're just not heard frequently. And it's a counterbalance for those of you who are looking to stay the course. Andrew, why don't you start us off?
Sure. So last month, October, the U.S. economy created 531,000 new jobs. Now, this was a surprise to the market because the Wall Street Journal had anticipated a rise of only 450,000 new jobs.
That's good.
So it's 80,000 more jobs than they had anticipated. Mm-hmm. This contributed to a drop in unemployment. It fell from 4.8% to 4.6%.
Very good.
September's jobs. So when they report these jobs, they later can go back and revise them based on more accurate information. September's jobs were raised from their initial report of 194,000 to 312,000 new jobs.
Wow.
August, those numbers were also adjusted from 366,000 to 483,000.
That's a lot of adjustments.
That's a lot of new jobs that they didn't anticipate or know about. So that's a total of 316,000 more jobs that the market had to digest for before November 1st than they had, and the market liked it.
That explains a little bit, and here's some more reasons why the market liked it. Corporate profits, Andrew, are exploding. Both business activity and new orders rose 7.5% and 6.2% to their all-time highs. The U.S. Services Sector Purchasing Managers Index, that's purchasing managers, came in at 58.7, which wouldn't mean anything if you didn't know that September's was only 54.9 and that it beat the expectation again of 58.2 estimate. The economy did grow, though a little slower in the third quarter. Growth is still growth, and GDP for the fourth quarter is expected to reignite back above what we had in the third quarter to the 5 to 6% range. That is really good. So here's one for you. During this period, real wage growth is now rising faster than it has in over 20 years at 5%. Now, that's a counterbalance to inflation. In fact, it's part of inflation. So inflation, bad news if it sticks around. Good news is wages are going up. Now, that's not everybody's wages. We know every individual, but that is a real number. It's the aggregate, and it is good news. Analysts are now less concerned because of all this about earnings slipping in the fourth quarter as many investors had feared.
And also consumer sentiment, despite all the challenges going on.
That are real. Yeah.
They are improving. The Institute of Supply Management's Service Index for September bumped up to a record 66.7 from 61.9 in September, and ahead of the 62% reading.
Another good thing. Now, bonds are not doing that well. They're not very attractive right now. Interest rate worries coming up ahead are keeping bonds depressed. The Barclays Bloomberg bond index is down 1.8%. Well, why is that good news? Well, it's not necessarily good, but it's not terrible. And it also means that investors have nowhere else to go but stocks. And this is another reason why they prefer stocks with little expectation for bonds.
That's right. In fact, in big stock years, bearish managers eventually feel compelled to join the bulls before the client's fear of missing out becomes too intense.
Right. So the storm is gathering. There's more momentum going for the market, and eventually those who've been dour on the market, they have to capitulate and give in for fear of their investors' retribution on
exactly.
That.
Now, also looking international, the markets there followed September's declines with October gains, similar to what we saw here in the U.S.
Yeah, after September's worst month of the year, and it wasn't very good, it was down a lot, one of the worst Septembers, but October's posted the best month of the year. In fact, last week alone, Andrew, the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and NASDAQ all set four consecutive day all-time highs. It was the longest simultaneous winning streak for the three indexes since October of 2017. Now, since 1980, all those Novembers have been the best month on average over in the S&P 500. So it's reasonable to anticipate that the typical holiday cheer we see adding lift to an already strong market. Andrew, if this continues, we could easily see a final boost through December and stocks sailing into year-end with 20-plus and even maybe more gains. In fact, to cap that, the S&P 500, as of last Friday, is already at 26%. The Dow Jones is at 20%. The large growth section is at 28%. And get this, small value, the smallest on-sale companies by those index, by that index, is up 37.8% as of last Friday, year to date.
Wow.
So these are all real points. They counterbalance some of the fear. If you think the market is disconnected from what's going on, that's because the news is telling us all the bad news of what is already happening and not looking at the things that are bubbling and the resilience that's going on in this economy. Even though destruction has taken place, there's reason to look forward to rising markets. The economy is expected to continue to grow. I'm David Maurice, a fee-only certified financial planner for Worthwhile Wealth Counsel.
And I'm Andrew Worley, Associate Advisor at Worthwhile Wealth Counsel.
We'll see you for another late-breaking great news when we can. Thank you.